a prophet, and the central agenda for the prophet was the proclamation of God's justice, that God's shalom, God's dream of the fullness of humanity living in communion with one another and with their God, was an order of justice. Jesus, no doubt, was very familiar with the passage from the prophet Isaiah in chapter 6, verse 8. He has told you, O mortal, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you, but to do justice, and to love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God. So any portrayal of Jesus that shows him only as a person of comfort and of healing for individuals, and that fails to take into account the social dimension of his proclamation and his action as prophet, is one that is lacking. Jesus spoke to the wholeness of humanity and to all of humanity, not only to single out single persons individually, but call us to account for the well-being of the whole community. No wonder then that some 2,000 verses in the scriptures have to do with God's overwhelming concern with the poor and with justice, and indeed with social justice for all people. There's recently been a debate about this in the media, and it has been shown that those who proclaim the full gospel have a responsibility to proclaim justice in the name of Jesus. And we who are privileged to bear his name and follow where he leads as his disciples are called to attend to respect the dignity of every human being, and indeed to strive for justice and peace among all people. Jesus is a man of the Spirit. Jesus is a man whose spirit expands to include the fullness of people and indeed of societies. Jesus is the justice of the kingdom, and we proclaim him as Lord of all.